Hello, good morning students. Welcome to our college YouTube channel. I am Assistant Professor Suryakant Adate from Sri Mudhai Devi Shikshan Samstha's Professor Sambhajirao Kadam College, Deur. Today's presentation is for BA Part 1st Bridge Course Lecture Series. Today's lecture is our second lecture and presentation topic is Review of Communication Skills and Reading Comprehension. In the last lecture of lecture series of Bridge course, we have studied the background of English, especially of 12th standard Yuvak Bharati. In this lecture, today we will learn communication skills and reading comprehension. In BA Part 1st Ability Enhancement Compulsory Course, English for Communication, we will study developing vocabulary, narration, English for general purposes, making inquiries, telephonic communication and description. In today's lecture, we will see communication skills one by one. Let us begin with developing vocabulary. Vocabulary is the very crux of human communication in any language. This communication topic aims to focus on various ways of developing vocabulary. It attempts to help the students of English to understand the meaning of the words and tries to give some clues that would be useful in developing vocabulary skills. It also includes word formation processes like affixation, compounding, conversion, clipping, blending, reduplication, and acronymy. In this unit, suffixes, prefixes, synonyms, antonyms, problem words and phrasal verbs are also covered. Secondly, narration skill. Narration is used for narrating past experiences. It is used in news reports, storytelling, and day-to-day informal conversation. This skill is very useful in your social, professional life, and it will be quite useful if you wish to become a creative writer. Narration is divided into two types, first person narrative and third person narration. The narrator can be a first person narrator where I speaks from his or her or their subject position. The other type of narration gives a third person point of view. It is told by a narrator who projects himself or herself as not being the part of the story and generally uses pronouns such as he, she, it, they, them, their, him, her, and its. Thirdly, English for general purposes. English language has become a link of the world. India is a multilingual country. Despite of various languages spoken here, English continues to be served as one of the widely spoken link languages in India. The demand of English for general purposes has increased in India. It is not only used for grammar teaching. It is designed to meet learners' day-to-day common needs and it should be learner-centered. ESP focuses on day-to-day common communicative needs and practices of the students. In the communication topic, you are going to study a certain language skills, especially speaking and writing. A learner can acquire these skills through consistent practice. Here, you are introduced to greetings, friendly communications, and self-introductions, as well as formal conversation, making small talk with a stranger, interacting at marketplace, writing SMS, writing emails, etc. Fourthly, making inquiries is also one of the important aspects of communication skill. Making inquiry or asking for information or giving instructions is a natural human tendency. See students, in your day-to-day life, you come across such incidents on many occasions. By making inquiry, you try to get the exact information about places, things, or even events. When you are in an unknown city or place, you make inquiries about residing place, about meals, or about sightseeing places. While making inquiries, you must be brief and precise as well as polite and gentle in his or her tone, so that you can get proper response and exact information from a respective person. And you must remember that you should not ask confusing questions or insufficient and irrelevant information. The objective of this skill is that students should be well acquainted with the skills of language for making inquiries and giving instructions in day-to-day life. Fifthly, telephonic communication. Today, mobiles and smartphones have become the most favorite gadgets in the hands of youth, elders, and even children. Telecommunication has entered in almost all walks of life and has become very vital in our modern life. So it is very necessary to acquire the skill of telecommunication. So here, we will learn appropriate language skills that can be used during telephone communication. The purpose of this skill is to make students familiar with the spoken English used in telephonic communication. It is formal as well as informal, but now we can only focus on the formal type. In modern business establishments, the receptionist, the switchboard operator, the office assistant are required to talk to people on telephone. It is used to give information, make inquiries, give messages, fix appointments, book a hotel room or a train or bus or plane ticket, to deal with complaints, etc. It needs to be clear and precise to be effective. It results in productive relationships and can yield better customer service and sale. The last communication skill is a description. It is necessary for first year students to learn how to use English for describing places. Ajinkya Tara and Mahabaleshwar, people, your mother and Virat Kohli, objects, mobile, laptop and fridge, and daily routine in life. They have to equip themselves with the knowledge and use of English structures and vocabulary to be able to meet the requirement of job market after their graduation. They may take up a job of a salesman, tourist guide, or journalism as their career. Whatever field they choose, they will need English for their efficient functioning in that field. The objective of skill are to get ideas about daily routine, practices in one's life, and to get encouraged to talk about you and talk about others in respect of daily routines. Second important part of today's lecture is reading comprehension. It includes prose and poems. Through these, students inculcate human values. In the first semester, the essay of A.G. Gardiner's On Saying Please, he talks about everyday civilities of behavior. He points out that good manners and bad manners affect our daily life very much. Mohan Rakesh, in his story in Passion's Shadow, gives very beautiful picture of human nature. Then William Wordsworth, in his The Solitary Reaper poem, gives description of a girl who sings a melancholy song. Rabindranath Tagore, a man of versatile genius, in his My School, he explains the circumstances in which he started his school in Bengal, Shantiniketan. Then another great dramatist, William Shakespeare, in his All the World is a Stage. Here Shakespeare compares life to a stage and has divided into 7 stages. Another great name in Marathi literature, V.V. Shirvadkar, his poem, The Secret, is metaphysical connotations. It is an expression of unheard melody. The starting line of this poem is, Kahi bolayache ahe, pan bolanar nahi. Reading comprehension of second semester starts with Mulkraj Anand's short story, The Lost Child, is about a child and his aspiration, demands and realization. It focuses on the awareness for parents. Missile Man of India, APJ Abdul Kalam's inspiring speech is really an intellectual feast for first year student. In his To My Countrymen, he speaks about the power of imagination. Mohan Singh's A Village Girl reflects a blend of romantic temper through a description of a village girl. Munshi Premchand, a great literary figure of Hindi literature, tells a story entitled My Elder Brother, Bade Bhai Sahab, of the relationship between brothers. Both live away from home in a hostel to study. The Tiger is a very beautiful poem of William Blake. He sees the power of God, majestic and terrifying. And last poem of Chandrakant Patil's, a poet, he tries to define world's complex relationship at the root of nature, society and civilization. It also narrates the power, strength and greatness of words in the poetic world. With these two topics, communication skill and reading comprehension, we conclude here. Thank you very much.